host a live Blooket game, you need only four things: a computer with an internet connection, a Blooket account, a question set, and players, whether that's students or peers to play the game. Let's start by creating an account or logging in at Blooket.com. Now we're going to find a question set first. You can use one of your own question sets found here in your My Sets area, or you can browse the over 20 million question sets that have been created by other users. To find one of these public question sets, click on Discover, then use the search bar or scroll down to view our featured sets to find one that suits your needs. Let's use one of these featured sets for this example. Click on it to open up the set preview page. Then click on Show Answers to review the set. And when you're ready to host, select Host. You can click through each of the game modes to see some more details about it. And when you found one that you like, select Host. Most games will give you two options for how you'd like the game to end. Option number one is time-based, where you can set exactly how long the game will run before it ends. Option number two is achievements-based, where participants will have to accomplish something in-game, like earning points or avoiding damage, in order to end the game. We'll use the time limit in this example and set it to 5 minutes for this game. When you scroll down, you'll find even more options. Each game mode is slightly different, but you'll see the following options for most of them. Show instructions will display brief game instructions before the game starts. Allow late joining will allow students to join after the game has already begun. And use random names, which generates random names for players. Leaving the setting disabled will allow students to enter their own nicknames. And we suggest that students use their real names to make after game reports more helpful, but some teachers just find it easier to generate random names when they're not using the games for formal assessments. And lastly, allow student accounts. Disabling this option will hide the pop-up that allows students to sign in and use their own accounts. We recommend leaving this enabled because students will earn tokens and experience points, which they can use to collect new blooks and items in the game. And I'll expand on that more in another video, but it's all up to you. When you're ready to go, scroll back up to the top and click Host Now. Now at this point, you should be sharing your screen with your virtual class or on a large screen in front of your in-person classroom. You can make this full screen or even mute the music right here in the top corner. Instruct students to log into the game using one of the following methods. They can scan the QR code with one of their devices, whether it's a tablet or a phone. They can visit play.blooket.com and enter this game ID, or you can always copy this join link and share this with students directly. This is particularly great for virtual classes. Now, once all of your students are in the game, click Start to begin the game. Students will see the instructions and the leaderboard on your big screen, and they'll be answering questions and playing the game on their own devices. Once the time is up, the achievement is met, or you choose to end the game early by selecting these arrows in the top right corner, the final standings will be displayed on your screen, and student reports with more details will be displayed on their own devices. Not only is this a fun way to review with your class, but it's also a great way to identify how well your students are grasping and mastering the different skills and topics being taught. And you can learn all about that in our video all about reports. Or if you want to learn how to create your own question set to use for live games or homework, click on this video over here. Either way, we'll see you in the next video.